Hi everyone, I'm Alba DJ and welcome to my channel! As y'all can see from the title of this video, I'm gonna be doing my everyday makeup routine. So this is not typically what everybody would do, but it's just how I like it. If I'm not going to a wedding or a party or any fancy event, this is my literal every single day makeup look. So since I'm not doing like a makeup tutorial, it's just my everyday makeup look, I decided to also do a short story time while I'll be applying my own makeup. And in today's story time, I'm going to be speaking about the first day, like day one of first year in varsity. It was really embarrassing, guys. Like, I wish that day never happened. I regret even going to school. Like, why did I go? And I'm not talking about, like, just going to varsity in particular. I'm just saying that day, why did I go to school? I should have just stayed in bed, honestly. But anyway, y'all will get to hear it. But without any further ado, let's get to this video. Okay, so let's get started. So usually, if I do a glam look, I actually prefer to do my foundation. Why am I lying? Usually when I do my everyday makeup look, I prefer to put my foundation first because I don't put that much eyeshadow and stuff like that. So it's like beneficial for me to put my foundation first. Then if I'm going to do a glam look, I then obviously foundation and everything and all of that. But that's for another video. So yeah, I'm going to start with my foundation. Like I said, this is not a tutorial, so I don't see the need of showing you every single product. Besides, I buy my products so many different places. You guys would just get confused and lost. But the one thing I can say for most people, Fit Me, it really, really works. I don't know. Can you guys see? Fit Me really works because you really find your color, guys. I used to be with Yardley, but it's either the shade would be too light or a little bit darker. But here, I found my baby. But okay. Shame, guys. I feel like all the guys watching this... It looks so weird. To all the guys watching this, pay attention, because one day your girl might just need your help, you know, and you should know your stuff, you know, at least know how to do the natural everyday look. Guys, don't judge me on how I put on foundation. This works for me. I'm not trying to teach anybody how to put on makeup. Do you, booze? Do you? Do what works for you. Anyway, I don't know if you guys can see. Oh my gosh, last week I got a weird pimple. And of course I popped it and it left a mark. That little evil little thing, it just left its mark, and I'm really hacked because, like, what was the reason? Anyway, I'm digressing. Let me get to the story. So it feels so weird talking like this, but it is what it is. Okay guys, so how my story begins. Well, I'm still one of those who uses the old brush. Okay. So what happened was, on my first day of varsity, it was the weekend before school started on the Monday, and my mom was dropping me off at my place of residence. At this point in time, I didn't have my class timetable at all. And of course, I was panicking because, like, school starts on Monday. I don't have a class timetable. I had a cousin already in the same varsity, my university. And he told me, no, you need to go to the online school portal and all of that. And obviously, at this point, I'm just like, there's a school portal, ITS. Like, I don't know these things. How do I access it? He's like, oh, you just need your student card and your PIN. Mind you, me, I don't know what PIN he's talking about. Like, I absolutely had no idea what he was talking about. I actually didn't put too much foundation because I don't like to, but that's just me. But yeah, it was telling me that I need to log in with a specific 5-digit PIN. And I was so confused because I don't remember being given a 5-digit PIN. And he told me that when you were applying, they gave you a paper that had 5 digits. Mind you, when that day happened, it's like you move from one station to the next as you getting everything together. And the person who gave me the PIN wasn't like, oh, this is going to be for your online portal, for school access and stuff like that. No, they're just like, here's your PIN, keep it safe. So obviously, initially, I thought, oh, they're going to ask for this PIN at the next table or something. But they never asked. And of course, I lost the paper. Anyway, moving forward, so I'm worried. Okay, I don't have the pin. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna miss class. And my mom and sister were not helping because they were telling me that if I miss a class, I could miss a whole two chapters because varsity lecturers do not wait for nobody. They just get started. And if you miss, you miss. They're not going to repeat or explain to you. You're just going to have to self-study and make sure you know it by the time of the exam. And obviously, I'm going to panic. Like, are you serious? Anyway, so here I am on a Sunday, day before school. My parents left. My mom saw that I was pretty, pretty stressed. Oh my gosh, I'm getting a rash. Okay. My parents saw that I was pretty stressed and they were just like, no, it's fine. There's usually an admin block. So you just go to the admin block and you will just tell them that you don't know your class timetable. Can you have your class timetable? And they'll give it to you. And I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. Which meant I had to get to school by 7 a.m. Because obviously, I don't know if class is going to start at 8. So I'm just like, okay, it's fine. 7 a.m. Get to the admin block. No biggie, you know? Lies I tell myself. Guys, when I got to that admin block, yo, Betuna, the line went behind the building. Mind you, it was two lines, actually. They went behind the building. And I'm just like, excuse me. Okay, fine. I keep it chill. I go and wait in line and I'm okay with that. I'm like, you know what, it's fine. I'm just like, you know what, it's fine. I'll go wait in the line. Like, it's okay. I mean, it's varsity. I'm sure these people are advanced. They're gonna do things pretty quickly. Lies I tell myself. Lies I tell myself. You know why? Because there was no such thing. The line barely moved, guys. And at this point, I had to wake up early. I didn't have breakfast. I'm stressing. And I'm just like, it's fine. Husa, I got this, you know? All right, cool. Then I wait in line. Next thing, the time becomes 8 o'clock. It becomes 9 o'clock. And I'm like, you know what? It's the whole day. I can miss the first two classes. I'll make up for it. It's fine. I don't want to miss a whole day of school, you know? I grew from that time, guys. I grew. I learned my lesson. Okay. So, at this point now, I'm just, like, so stressed, okay? And the line is barely moving, and I'm just like, okay, I'm starting to get hungry. And I'm the type of person, when I'm hungry, I get a headache, my eyes get sore, like, the inside of my eye. Actually, it's not even eyes, it's one eye. Always attacks one eye. And then I start to feel, like, a little bit weak, you know? And I'm just grumpy, so I'm just like, no, it's fine, you know? It's all good. I'm just gonna wait a little longer. Hopefully it'll move. And next thing, it's like 10 o'clock. The line is barely moving. Maybe I moved like 5 people forward. So then I decide, okay, on my way to school, I saw one of these vendor people on the side of the street. Let me go get a snack. And you know when you start to think about leaving the line, for some reason the line actually moves. Like it starts to really move. So now I'm just like, yeah, by the time I come back, I would have missed my spot. Like, the person that I asked to keep my spot would be inside now. So I'm like, okay, that's fine. It's all right. It's all cool. I don't know if you guys can even see the progress, but it's there. Okay, cool. So I'm just like, you know what? It's fine. It's cool. Hello, honey. Okay. So I'm just like, okay, fine. Let me wait a little bit longer because it seems like the line is really moving. I have a sweet in my pocket. Let me just eat the sweet and I'll be fine. Again, lies I tell myself. So, as time goes forward now, guys, oh my gosh. I was starting to feel a little bit dizzy, you know? And at that point, I'm in front of the building, but there's still a number of people. So I was just like, it's okay. Let me just ask this person to hold my space. Let me go and get a packet of chips, you know, so a girl can be strong enough for who knows how many hours. And at this point, I really was so stressed. I was so scared. I'm like, guys, I missed so many classes. Like, at that point, it's now going to 11. I missed 4 classes. That's what I'm thinking. Okay, let me not dwell on that too much. But yeah. So at this point, I'm just like, girl, talk to this person. I tell the person behind me, I'm coming back. I just want to go get something. The person's like, cool. I also told the person in front of me because I don't want beef when I came back. I was like, it's not about that time, guys. No. Little did I know that the next two steps I'm going to take are the steps to the ground. Anyway, guys, I don't know if y'all can see the progress because this lighting is making me look pale as hell, but we move. So, okay, now at this point, guys, this is when I made the decision, okay, girl, let's go get food. I take two steps, and then next thing I'm waking up on the floor. I got so hungry and so stressed and so dizzy. I didn't even feel that I was that so dizzy that I fainted. Guys, I fainted. Straight out fainted. Which is so weird because when I remember it, I only took two steps. But when I opened my eyes and lifted my head, I was probably five steps further than I remember taking. So it was really weird. Like, I know I was there. I took two steps. Now I'm here. But I'm on the floor. It was so weird. So I'm opening my eyes and I'm just like, what is going on? You know? And that's when I realized, first, did I fall to the ground? Wait, did I faint? Guys, yo, that kind of scared me because I've never ever fainted in my life. I've never been close to fainting. So that was like really new for me. I was just like, this is not on. And then everybody around me, like every single person who was in line, was just staring at me. These mother effers were just staring at me. Point blank, staring. Not even one. I was like, hey, are you okay? Let's have it. No, they're standing in line just looking at me like, and then? What's going on here? I won't lie, I was touched. And I wish I could, like, pull revenge on all those people. But it's fine. Even the person that I even told, like, I'm coming back. Go get that person, watch me faint. And just let me be, bruh. Great. Kudos. Kudio. Okay. I realized my setting that I'm on the floor. I'm a bit dizzy. And of course, then it registered that, damn, I just fainted. And then I decided, you know what? I'm feeling a little bit weak. And I saw a sign that said clinic on the school premises, so I'm just gonna walk there, see the doctor, check up what's up with me, because at this point I'm like a little bit worried, so I just wanted to make sure everything was okay. And obviously I start walking forward, and then finally one person comes up to me and is like, hey, are you okay? What's wrong? Like, I saw you just fainted. And he can see I'm a little bit delirious, but he's still asking. But I appreciate the fact that he even came up to me and was like, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, I'm all right. I'm just going to go to the clinic. And then he's like, can I walk you there? And I'm just like, yes, please. Because why are you even asking? Like, on a serious note, why are you even asking, bro? You can see I need help. All right. And then, but I was happy because at least somebody came to, like, what if I fainted? At least when I did faint, I fainted on the grass. So that's good. Now imagine I kept walking and I fainted on concrete. Ah, guys. Yo. But anyway, that was just that. And he did actually walk me to the... I need to concentrate on this because I always have issues with this. But he did walk me to the clinic and he actually stayed up until I had to literally go inside. So I was really thankful for that. And I took his numbers, he took my numbers because he wanted to make sure that I was okay afterwards. And I found that really, really sweet. But I went inside, I told the nurse what happened, and then I told the doctor, this is what happened. I had to wake up early, I went to the admin block, I was pretty stressed, I didn't have breakfast, I'm still hungry, I'm feeling a little dizzy. And you know when they give you those sugar supplement things to boost up your energy? And then she told me, no, everything is fine. Nothing hectic is happening with me. It's just because I was stressed. I was very anxious. And I didn't eat. So all of that together was just a mixture for fainting. So that kind of made me happy, because for a minute I thought something's wrong with me, guys. Like, I have never fainted before, so why am I fainting today? And then she gave me a letter that told me that I'm not okay, I'm kind of weak and stuff like that, so I need to get to the front of the line at the admin block. That's what's up. And so, of course, I went back, because now, after the sugar supplements, whatever she got me, I felt much better. I actually went to go buy a packet of chips to nibble on. Then I went to the admin block with my letter that said, "Security, take me to the front. Not about this today." At this point, I was over now going to class. I didn't care. After I just fell and got embarrassed, I didn't care. Yo, not anymore. Okay, so at the admin block, obviously, I went to the front. And also, I made sure I looked weak. Like, I felt better, like, much better, but I made myself look like, I'm not okay, I feel a little weak. Yeah, guys, we wanted to get out of there, so I had to, okay? I was not playing that game, to be honest. And they did help me. I got my timetable, so I finally knew. And turns out I had, like, 3 classes. And they did start, of course, at 8 o'clock, which meant I missed it, and only to find out later there wasn't even class, the lecture wasn't there. Beauty plays with people's minds. But yeah, at this point now, I was walking back home to my res, and I felt much better. I had my timetable, and then guess what? Something tells me, go through your phone. Maybe you wrote the pin down somewhere. I don't know. Just check your phone. I found the pin. I found the mother effing pin. That leads me to the school portal where I could access my timetable. To be honest, guys, at that point, I had a blonde hairstyle, so I knew whoever saw me faint that day would remember me for the rest of the week. And I swear I did not want to go to school. Like, I really, really, really did not want to go to school at all. And that kind of hurt my feelings, because I'm like, y'all gonna see me thriving, looking healthy, but y'all didn't even help me. But yeah, you know, I embraced it, because what can I say? Like, there's nothing I can do about it. It is what it is. I got my timetable. I fainted. I found out there wasn't even class at all, so I was stressing for nothing. I got embarrassed for nothing. And that was my first day in varsity. And you know, you expect your first day to be like, it's very chill, you're gonna explore the culture, explore how people are, find out where the cool spots are, the cafeteria, everything. Like, I'm supposed to embrace this new experience. I'm supposed to be like, ooh, I'm in varsity, y'all. I'm no longer in high school. But no, I'll be going to the admin block to faint on my first, very first day. Think about it, it's funny though. Oh my gosh. Ah, wow. I still don't know why we do that. Does it even help? Not really. Not for me. But yeah, so to end off my look, I always, always have to have lip gloss. Yeah, guys. Lately, I'm obsessed with lip gloss. It does something to me. It really does something to a girl. But anyway, it is klar. And I look cute. Hey, girl. But yeah, guys, that is my first day of varsity. It was really embarrassing. It was really sad. I wish it didn't even happen. But I guess now I'm going to learn that, you know what? If you miss something, stop stressing. If it's not gonna give you money or give you something that you've been wanting, don't stress, hey? Because it was only day one out of so many days, so I regret. Which is why even now when I tell my little cousins who like are in matric and about to start varsity, I tell them don't stress, you know? Take it one day at a time. If you do miss a class, you're not gonna miss so much like a crazy person. Like you can actually go to the lecture afterwards, ask them, what did we do today? I missed class because of 1, 2, 3. And they actually will tell you. Like whoever likes scaring people telling you lectures are how. It's a lie. It's a lie. But anyway, let me show you guys the finished look. Okay, you guys, as y'all can see, I'm in a different setting from the one I was at just previously because I want a better lighting so that you guys could actually get a proper look of how I did my makeup. So this is my average day-to-day makeup look. I keep it pretty simple. I just put on foundation. I use neutral colored eyeshadow, so my brown, orange, a little bit of maroonish sometimes, just to add that little bit of pop of color, and eyeliner and mascara, and then I'm done. As y'all can see, I don't actually do my eyebrows when I have my normal makeup look. If I do a glam look or I'm going somewhere pretty nice, then I'm likely to do my eyebrows, but not today. With my everyday makeup look, I actually don't do my eyebrows. I just brush them into shape and that's pretty much it. And I usually put on lip gloss and sometimes nude lipstick and then lip gloss on top, which I love it. But to keep it simple, it's usually just lip gloss. And that's my makeup look. But I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I really enjoyed doing it for you guys. And I hope you enjoyed the story time. I pray for those who are still going to varsity that you have better experiences. Learn it from me. Don't panic. Don't stress. If things are not just in order, relax. Take it one item at a time. It's only day one. Usually in day one, you're getting to know each other as students and lecturer. Not much is happening, so you'll be fine. And thank you guys so much again for watching this video. I really enjoyed doing it for you guys. Now I actually feel like going somewhere. I don't know. I might just go buy a drink at McDonald's or something. I don't know. I can't let this go to waste. And don't forget to give this a thumbs up. Hit that like button. Don't forget to share. And please comment down below any other videos you'd like to see me do. And if you haven't, subscribe. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.